good, and so's a queen. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between on Cart Sharks. And here's the host of Cart Sharks, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Thank you very much. Welcome to Cart Sharks. Thank you for joining us. They are very kind. Thank you. Thank you so much. That was a very inventive opening poem from Dale Kern of Marion, Ohio. Thank you, Dale, for sending that in. Hey, we finished off last time by crowning a new champion. Didn't get a chance to play the money cards for the big money. We're going to do that right now. Let's welcome back Diana Jones. Hello, Diana. Nice to see you.
Nice to be back.
Why don't you remind us about yourself?
Yes, I'm a retired school teacher turned entrepreneur. I have my own giftware business. I'm married and live in Long Beach, and right now I'm very heavy into cake decorating and reupholstering.
Last time we talked, you were busy, and you're busy. You keep adding things. You have a fascinating life.
Thank you.
You ready to make a lot of money now, I hope?
I sure am. I hear it's time.
That's good. Yes, it is. We'd love to do it. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on, Diana. Pop on up there. Well, you won $200 in the game, Diana. That's yours to keep. Now we're going to give you new money to play with. This time you're going to bet that money. Janice is dealing three cards across the bottom, $200. Second level, we add another $200, three more cards. $50 minimum bets till you get to that top card, that big bet. There you must bet at least half the money. You ready?
Yes.
Don't be nervous. Relax.
I'm nervous.
Let your intuitions go. Oh, no, you're among friends. The fact that a couple of million people are bothering... Don't let that bother you. Okay, get over there. Here's $200. I like that. Get over there. We'll give you the choice of two base cards, starting with a five. You want to play that or you want to change it, Diana?
I'd like to change it, Jim.
All right. I hope you make a good change because you've got to play this one. Oh, yeah.
Right.
Great card. Two. $200 and a two, Diana.
I'll say $200 higher.
The whole thing. Yeah, you got to go with that two. $200 higher than a two. Yes, it's a nine. $400 now and a nine, okay. Diana.
A nine is not one of your better cards, so I'm just going to go $50 lower.
See if we can buy a better card. $50 lower than a nine. Yes, it's an eight. Didn't get too much a better card, but you did add another $50, Diana.
Let's see. The eight is right in the middle, so there's nowhere to go but guess. So I'm gonna go $50 lower.
Still gonna go lower. All righty. Well, you got one low one there, one high
That's
one, so
right.
You're right up the middle. $50 lower than an eight. It's a four. You're right. Pretty good card there with $500. As we move the four up,
okay.
We add the other $200 in betting money. Diana, you've got $700.
Okay. A four is a really good card, I think, Jim. So I'm going to go $500 higher.
All right. We're due for a face card now. $500 higher than a four. Yes, it's a face card. That's what we like. Well, $100 and a jack, Diana, and three cards to go.
I'm going to stay very cool, calm, and collected about this. I have $1,200. A jack is a really good card. I'm going to go $1,000 lower.
Big bet. $1,000 lower than a jack. With a six, you've got $2,200. Diana, you're doing great.
Okay. A six is kind of a card. I'm going to bet $200 that it will be higher.
Higher. Let's see if we can buy a good one. $200 higher than a six. Oh, yes, perfect. What a great time for an ace. We move up with a big bet. You've got to bet $1,200. You can bet more. You've got $2,400 and an ace, Diana. What's your big bet?
Well, it's all or nothing at all. I'm going to bet $2,400 that it is lower.
All or nothing.
Can I turn around while you turn the card around?
You want to turn around? You don't want to peek? Hey, Diana,
what?
Turn around. You got it! $2,400! Nice going! Nice going! Don't turn away with that kind of money. With the $200 in the game, that means in one quick game, you have won $5,000. That's terrific.
That's fantastic. Oh,
we'll have a new challenger start a new match right after we take time out for this. Hello there. Just talking with the audience, getting called with a little red light going on. Okay. We're talking with Diana Jones, our champion, who won $5,000. That's nice, Diana.
Well, it's fantastic.
You played those cards so well, I must say. You got absolutely good mileage out of all of them.
I tried to be very cool, calm, and collected about the whole thing.
And you were, until you turned your back and got afraid.
Oh, I've seen too many aces come up.
No, beautifully played. We're very happy for you.
Thank you.
Let's try to defend the title right now. We're going to meet a new challenger, so let's open the board and get to the cards, if you will. Go ahead. Janice and Ann, you'll start loading in the cards, please, with two brand new decks of cards as we start a new match with this challenger on Card Sharks. Louise Silk. Hello, Louise. Welcome.
Hi. Nice to be here.
Nice to have you here. Won't you tell us about yourself?
Okay. I'm a sales representative for a major copier corporation, and I'm newly engaged. I'm from West L.A.
Well, that's nice. What do you mean, newly engaged?
Just got engaged.
Oh, how long before? How long are you planning marriages nowadays?
It's going to be a while.
Going to be a while?
Uh-huh.
All right. Well, good luck with it, Louise, and good
Thank
luck
you.
Here in the match. Good luck to both of you. Each player has her own deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go on the air. Diana, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Louise, the challenger, plays the lower cards, the blue cards. But before you can begin playing the cards, you must first win a high-low toss-up question based on a poll of 100 people. Diane, we start with a question to you. Our man on the street went all the way to Italy, where he asked 100 women in Rome.
Okay.
This week, all heard the tales about Rome, has a man pinched you on the fanny? How many Italian women said yes?
Oh, I know they pinch the tourists, but I'm not sure about the homegrown variety. I would say out of 100, 30.
30 this week have been pinched on the fanny, Louise. Higher or lower?
No, I think you're not Italian men. I'd say higher.
You say higher. If it is higher, you go to the board first. If not, it'll be Diana. The actual number of Italian women who had been pinched by a man on the fanny is zero. It is not higher. Absolutely none. And Diana goes to the board first. And Diana, you were on the right track because we asked our man on the street about that. Interestingly enough, the Italian men do not pinch Italian women. They pinch foreigners. My question is, from that view, how can you tell one from... Diana, we'll take a look at your base card. You've got a jack. Want to play it?
Good card, Jim. I'll go lower.
Lower than a jack? Yes, it's a nine.
Okay.
Remember, you can freeze at any time.
I'll freeze.
And you'll freeze right there. So we move the freeze bar over, and we can't take those cards away from you. And, of course, you didn't make a mistake. That keeps Louise away from her cards. Louise, we asked 100 women. Have you ever told someone the jewel you were wearing was a diamond when it was really a fake? How many women admitted they had?
Okay, knowing how there's a lot of fake jewelry, I'd say 45.
45. Higher or lower, Diana?
I think women are afraid to say it if it's not real because the other person may know. So I'm going to go lower.
You say lower?
Yes.
They would lie if they had a chance, right? They could get away
right,
with it.
Exactly.
The actual number of women who told someone they were wearing a diamond when it was really a fake is 23. It's lower, Diana. Yep. Diana, you won the question. You have the right to change this nine now if you'd like.
I don't like that nine.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck. You must play a four.
Four. Good card. I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a four? No, it's a two. And it was good you froze because we can only lose that one card as Louise takes a look at a jack. Gotta play it, Louise.
Okay, I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower? No, it's another jack. And that's not lower, so neither player advances, and Ann fills in the spaces. We go to you, Diana, with this question. We polled 100 Iowa farmers and asked them, were you born in a hospital or at home? How many farmers said they were born at home?
Well, I think years ago it would be a really high number. But nowadays, I don't think it would be so high. I'll say, 27.
27, Louise.
I think it's a lot higher.
Higher than that?
Yeah.
The actual number of farmers who were born at home is 75, Louise. Well, they're still doing it.
Great.
Louise, you have a jack. You have the right to change it if you'd like. What are you going to do?
Oh, I'll keep it. And I'll go higher. I mean, excuse me, lower.
Okay. Lower than a jack? Oh, no, it's an ace. Maybe you should have followed those first instincts. Yes, Diana gives you a chance to play off the four and call this.
It's got to be higher, Jim.
Higher than a four? It is. It's a five.
Five is a pretty good card. I'm going to go one more card and say higher.
Higher than a five. Yes, it's a seven.
I'm going to freeze.
And she'll freeze. Diana needs just one card as Anne fills in the space. Louise needs four. We're at sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Louise, we asked 100 people in a previous studio audience. At this moment, do you have a toothache? How many unlucky people did have a toothache?
Oh. Well, knowing how good dentists are today, I'll say only two.
Two. Higher or lower, Diana?
Just to go with the odds, I'll say a little bit higher.
You say higher, and the actual number of poor souls who had toothaches is eight. It's higher, Diana. Sudden death, Diana. You've got an interesting decision to make because you have a seven. You have the right to change it and try to turn this one card over. But if you made a mistake, Louise wins. However, you can force Louise to play off the jack. She'd have to turn over four cards or the game is yours. You want to play it or pass it?
I like to be a master of my destiny, but somehow I think the wise move is to let Louise play.
Louise, you've got to go all the way to win the first game in the match. One mistake and it belongs to Diana. You've got a jack. Call this.
I'm going to still go lower.
Lower than a jack. It is an eight. You're one-fourth of the way there.
Okay. I'm going to have to say lower.
Lower than an eight? Yes, it's a four. You're halfway there.
Okay, well, four is my lucky number. I'm going to say higher.
Higher than a four? Yes, another jack. Okay, one card to go.
Lower.
If this is lower, Louise wins. If it's not, Diana wins the first game of the match for the win. Yes, she did it with four cards. Wow. Congratulations. Sensational. I think you did the right thing. Put her on the spot. She was equal to it. Game number one to the challenger with $100. We'll be setting up for game number two coming up right after this. Challenger leads one game to nothing with $100, Louise. So the pressure's now on the champion. Diana, you need this. Anne's loading in the cards. Same two decks of cards. If you can remember what cards have been played, it might help your strategy. Diana, we left off with the next question going to you. We asked 100 women, if there really is a heaven and a hell, do you think you'll make it to heaven? How many women thought they would make it into heaven?
Well, I think all of them hope they'll make it, but I would say I'm going to play 50. I'm just going to be real safe on this. 50.
Right up the middle. Put the pressure on you, Louise. She says 50.
Oh, well, we're all so good as women. I'll say higher.
You say higher. I think most women think they deserve to go to heaven.
Sure.
The actual number of optimistic women who think they'll make it into heaven is 78. Oh. It's higher, Louise. Yes. And your base card, Louise. A five. Do you want it?
Can I change it? I like to change it.
You'd like to change it? All right. Let's see if we can improve it. A queen, yes, a little bit of improvement.
Okay, lower.
Lower than a queen. It is an eight.
Okay, I'll freeze.
And she's going to freeze it on that one card, and the audience kind of agrees that's a good decision. Louise, we asked 100 people in Plains, Georgia.
Oh.
Have you ever eaten a bagel? How many people in Plains, Georgia said they had eaten a bagel?
A bagel. Well, a lot of people have eaten bagels. I'd say, 79
have had a bagel in Plains, Georgia, Diana.
I'd say a lot of people have eaten bagels, but it's going to be just a little lower, Jim.
You say it'll be lower than that. I know in Plains they serve peanut butter on a
sandwiches.
Bagel. It's just, The actual number of people in Plains, Georgia who had eaten a bagel is 29. Diana, very much lower. And a look at the champion's base card. It is a five.
Oh, I think I'd like to change it.
And you're also changing the five. That's a surprise. We'll get a 10.
Okay, I like that better. I'll go lower.
Lower than a 10? No, it's a queen. It's not lower. Louise, play off the eight and call this card.
Okay, I'm going to say lower.
Lower than an eight? No, it's a king. It's not lower. You couldn't take advantage of it. And we'll go to the next question to you, Diana. We asked 100 housewives across the country. When you're giving a dinner party, which bothers you more? When your guests arrive much too early or when they arrive much too late? How many housewives said it bothers them more when their guests arrive much too early?
I really don't think that that many guests arrive that early to have a problem. I would say 20.
20.
Yes.
20 would be upset if the guests arrived too early.
Well, if they're anything like me, I take to the last minute, so I'll say it's a lot higher.
You say higher than that?
Yeah.
The actual number of housewives who are more bothered when their guests arrive too early is 33. It's higher. Louise. And Louise, you can change that 8 now if you'd
like. I will change that.
And it becomes a 5. Call this
okay,
one,
Louise. I'm going to say higher.
Higher than a 5? Yes, okay. It's a 9.
I'm going to freeze.
And you'll freeze. Louise needs 2 cards. Diana needs 4. And again, we're at sudden death. Louise, we asked 100 people in a previous studio audience, have you ever cheated at cards? How many admitted they had?
Oh, let's see. Well, let's see. If you could cheat here, I'll say 75.
75 have cheated at cards, Diana.
When I was little, I used to look at my opponent's glasses when we played Old Maid, so I know I have. But I would say, a little bit higher.
Higher. Well, the actual number of people who have cheated at cards, and we won't let them on Card Sharks, is 44, not higher, Louise. Louise, you've got control. You have a 9. You can change it and try the 2 cards, or you can force Diana to play with a 4.
No, I'll pass.
You'll pass it.
Thank you, Diana.
She did it. You've got to do it to tie it up. You've got to turn over 4 straight cards, or we have a new champion. You've got a 10. Call this.
Not going to let me change my 10.
No, you didn't win the question.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a 10. Yes. You've got a 6.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 6. It's a 10. You're still in it.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a 10. Another 10. It's not lower. And we have a new champion, Louise. Congratulations. Congratulations. Diana, has been a profitable stay. Thank you. You're a delight.
Thank
one
you.
Win, and you're leaving us with $5,000. That's not bad.
Not bad.
Thank you, Diana Jones. Louise, come on down here. Congratulations.
Oh, I don't believe it. I can't believe it.
You feel lucky?
Yes, very lucky.
Good. We'll see if she is lucky with the money cards coming up right after this. All righty, a little encouragement from the audience. Louise, we're ready for the money cards.
Okay.
All set?
Yep.
Brand new deck of cards, all shuffled and cut. Our lovely Janice Baker is going to deal them out there now. And you'll have 7 cards, $200 on the bottom level, $200 when you move up to the second level. 7 cards in all, $50 minimum bets. The big decision, that big bet where you must bet at least half the money. Good luck, Louise.
Thank
you.
You
played a great game. Let's top it off with the great money cards. Here's $200. And your first base card, which is a jack.
Okay.
You want to play that? Want to change it?
I'm going to bet $200 that it's lower.
Whole thing, right away.
Right.
$200 lower than a jack. And it is very much lower, a 3. 400 and a 3, Louise.
I'm going to bet $400 that it's higher.
$400 higher than a 3. Yes, and a big king. That's a way to get him. $800 and a king, Louise.
I'm going to bet half that it's lower.
How much?
Half.
Half of it on a king?
Okay, I'll bet it all.
No,
also.
Don't let me talk you into anything, but there are 52 cards, 4 kings and 4 aces. So it's up to you, your decision. But what are the odds?
I'll bet all of it that it's high. Lower.
I hope we're right. I hope we haven't talked you into anything.
Really.
But I must admit, those aces and kings, you pretty well have to go with them if you get a chance. I hope so. Lower than a king for $800. Oh, no. Oh.
See? I should have guessed my own thing.
Well, you're not out of it.
Okay.
You're still out of the other $200 of betting money. We move the king up, give you the $200, Louise. 4 cards to go, and it's still a good card. I don't care what happened.
Okay, I'll bet $200 that it's lower.
Come on, let's get it going now. $200 lower than a king? Yes, it's an 8. That should have happened down there, darn it.
I'll bet $50. That it's lower.
All right, let's see if we can improve on it. $50 lower than an 8. It is. It's a 6. You're up to $450, Louise. Doing good again.
I'll bet $100 that it's higher.
$100 higher than a 6. And it is again a jack. You made a great comeback there, Louise. As we move the jack up, you must bet at least $275. You have $550. What's your big bet?
I'll bet all of it that it's lower.
You go so strong with the jacks and you're hesitant with the kings. I hope you're right. $550 lower than a jack. Hit it! Great comeback. Great comeback.
Thank you.
You did good. That's a good comeback. $1,100. Come on down here, Louise. That's nice. Congratulations.
Thank you.
$1,300 in all.
Oh, great.
We'll be right back right after we take time out for this. Louise Sook will be in a new challenger when next we meet on Card Charge. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive a Dakota bedspread, very fluffy, beautifully designed in contemporary applique graphics or outline quilted traditional prints furnished by Dakota. And some of our contestants will receive cool-ray fashionable sunglasses that win admiring stares while protecting from annoying glare. 86 eye-catching style, see what you're missing with cool-ray polarized sunglasses. And Fine and Country tableware by Washington Forge. Beautiful, sleek with handles and mirror-bright stainless steel dishwasher safe from Washington Forge. And see the meal you're cooking. Airtight bags, go from freezer to hot water, no mess, no bother. Dates and seal the meal simplifies your life. And Miro's Electric Water Pizzeria. Professional style pizza from frozen mix or scratch. Save 70% energy over range ovens. Water Pizzeria from Miro. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.